Belinda Audiobooks presents this unabridged recording of Aussie Bites, read by Stig Weems. Be sure to check us out on the web at www.belinda.com. The Too-Tight Tutu by Sherryl Clark. Chapter 1. Mary wanted to be a ballerina. In her dreams, she saw herself gliding across a stage in a silver tutu with lots of sparkly sequins and silver ballet shoes. But she had three problems. There was no ballet school in the small country town where she lived. Even if there had been, her mother said, "We can't afford it. Ballet schools are very expensive." And Mary thought she was too fat to be a ballerina. Her little brother Sam said so all the time. He also said,
"You're ugly."
And,
"You're dumb."
But mostly he said,
"You're too fat to be a ballet dancer, Mary."
Other people weren't as rude, but Mary knew that they thought so too. She was always picked last for t-ball, and she always came last in running races. Still, she knew that she could be a ballet dancer if only she had the chance. One day, a tall, skinny woman came to Mary's school. She said,
"I'm a ballet teacher. If enough children are interested, I will teach ballet once a week at the local hall."
All the girls ran home to ask their parents. Finally, eight girls signed up, enough for a class. On the first day, the teacher stood waiting for them in the old wooden hall. Her long blonde hair was tied up in a bright scarf and big gold rings dangled from her ears.
"Look at her shoes," Mary's friend Susie whispered. "Real ones, with points."
Mary stared enviously at the worn pink shoes and the ribbons laced around the teacher's ankles.
"Girls, girls."
A loud clap of hands.
"My name is Shirley Lane. You can call me Miss Lane or Madame."
She stressed the dame.
"I realise this is your first day, but..."
Miss Lane pursed her lips at the lineup of t-shirts, shorts and runners in front of her.
"You will need black leotards, pink tights and ballet shoes for class."
Mary's heart rose at the thought of her very own feet in those pink ballet shoes. Then it sank into her stomach. She felt sick. Mum had grumbled about the cost of the classes. When she heard about the leotard, tights and shoes, she'd just say no. But Miss Lane gave them no time to worry about such problems.
"Bare feet, girls, off with those clodhoppers. Now, positions of the feet. First position."
Soon they were all using old wooden chairs as bars to balance against. Mary carefully twisted her feet around and back, then her arms, up and down, rounded nicely, up and down, out and up.
"My arms ache,"
hissed Susie.
"When are we going to dance?"
"No talking, girls,"
Miss Lane called.
"Up, down."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.